Hey guys, Lucas here and welcome at kNews.space. It's been a while and this short video format is a new attempt to make launch videos more sustainably. As you can hopefully tell, Delta 4 is not quite dead yet. Today is its final flight in the single stick configuration using only one core orange booster. The tiny ones on the side help it to get off the ground more quickly, aka increasing its thrust to weight ratio. Each second spent firing upwards means you fight gravity, and that battle is one you really don't want to fight longer than necessary. Instead, you better get some horizontal speed going, doing a so-called gravity turn to the side. During flight, you'll as always see Delta 4 dropping its empty fuel tanks, which is of course called staging. That doesn't mean flying to space is staged, but the total rocket power is released in stages. Strap-ons, and by that I mean boosters, count only half a stage, while the center core and upper stage count as one. One event you should keep your eyes glued to the screen for is the upper stage's nozzle extension. Unlike others, it is not fixed but extends down just after separation. The mechanism shown here is only an artistic representation made by myself, so don't take it too literally. I tried to get close, but it's far from being perfect. You might wonder what this is good for, and the reason is simply to keep the interstage shorter while maintaining a high thrust efficiency. The high pressure gas leaves the nozzle and wants to extend in all directions. There is no physical reason for thrust to push forwards only, so in order to direct as much of the exhaust backwards, you use a nozzle extension. The goal is for the pressurized gas to reach ambient pressure at the tip so that it has no more incentive to move outwards. However, in space you have to compromise because the ambient pressure is pretty much zero, and dividing by almost zero leads to an almost infinitely large nozzle extension you'd need to get all the efficiency out of it. At some point, the added mass of the extension kills all the gains, so you make a cut. As payload up top, which unveiled itself shortly after separation, is a GPS satellite. These have to be replaced on their orbits once in a while because they simply run out of fuel, which they need to keep the desired position. That doesn't mean they hover on a certain spot though. They orbit Earth at 22,000 kilometers, but these orbits get shifted around by, for example, the moon's gravity or even solar winds. So in order to stay in one particular orbit and for GPS to work as intended, they have to burn their thrusters. Changing the orbit would lead to a gap in the constellation, which is carefully picked and placed so that you always have at least four satellites above you in the sky, no matter where on Earth you are. Be careful though, some GPS sensors like those typically used on smartphones have often problems to get a good enough signal in the woods. So you ironically get lost when you need GPS the most. Always carry a compass when hiking. Even if you have no clue where you are going into one direction only, you will always get somewhere. Unlike moving in circles, which is, by the way, always the case unless you move perfectly straight. Okay, that shall be it for this episode. Special thanks and shoutouts to my Patreon supporters who have not yet lost hope, but also to all the others who helped me to make more videos in recent years. I really hope I'm back, and please let me know what you think about this format. I know it's not KSP, but please understand that playing KSP and making videos using KSP are two separate things. One is great and the other can be quite annoying. Anyways, I hope to still see you in the next one if you like. Auf Wiedersehen and thank you for watching.